Welcome to part three of our four-part series on learning how to TIG weld aluminum. In part one, you learned some static exercises on retraining your hands to hold the TIG torch and feed the filler metal. In part two, you learned how to start, establish, and control the weld puddle. Today, we're going to work on adding the filler metal to the weld puddle. So get yourself situated, and remember, read and follow all labels and your owner's manual. So what we're going to do is we're going to start off with a simple dab and move technique. Okay, we're going to start and establish the arc. We're going to add the filler metal to the edge of the weld puddle. Then we're going to move over. Add and move, add and move, add and move. So that little dab and move motion eventually will turn into a fluid motion with your torch hand, and you're just picking up the frequency that you're adding the filler metal. Okay, so we're going to start that right now. Adding more puddle, more pedal, more pedal, and there's that weld puddle. Adding the filler metal, move, dab, 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 dab and move, dab and move, dab and move. So we want to keep repeating that dab and move exercise. Okay, I'm going to start that again. There's my weld puddle. Dab, move, dab, move, dab, dab, dab. Now I'm not throttling up and down on the pedal. I'm just keeping a consistent pedal. Now, eventually, as you pick up the frequency you're adding the filler metal, you're going to be able to just continue moving along. Now typically the filler metal is being added to the leading edge of the puddle. You're not right underneath the tungsten because you don't want that energy to start balling up your filler metal. Okay, let's try and take another look at that. Remember to only put one or two passes on your test piece so that it doesn't get too hot. We're going to do again that dab and move. Increasing the amperage. There's that shiny spot. Dab, move, dab, move. You can see I'm adding the filler metal just to the leading edge of the puddle. And then I'm kind of pulling it away from the arc. I don't want to leave it sitting under there because, again, that arc stream is going to start melting my filler metal and I don't want that. If you ever see a big booger on the end of your filler metal, it's because you left it in the arc stream too long. Set that one aside again. Take another new piece. Now we're just going to do another continuous run. Now the rhythm you add the filler metal will determine your ripple pattern of the puddle. If you add the filler metal faster, you will have tighter puddles. If you add the filler metal slower, your puddles will be a little bit wider. So like here you can see my puddle profile is a little wider. Here it's a little tighter.
Okay, I'm going to show you that puddle pattern one more time, where you have maybe a wider puddle profile and then a tighter puddle profile. Ultimately, if this is a structural application, you would get the most strength by overlapping the previous puddle at least by 50% or more. Okay, you don't want the toes of the weld curving in to the center of your weld bead, because if this was a critical application, that potentially could be where a crack would start.
So I'm going to start off and do wide puddle profile first. And now I'm going to do a tighter profile.
So you can see simply how I just kept on moving the torch before adding more filler metal. And then I just sped up the frequency I was adding the filler metal. Okay. Again, if this was structural application, this tighter profile is going to be stronger. You don't want those toes of the weld to be curving too far in towards that center of the weld puddle. Two more things I want you to practice. One is post-flow gas is coming out of your TIG torch after you feather off the foot pedal at the end of your weld puddle. Okay, keep your TIG torch at the end of the puddle because it has to shield that molten puddle while it's cooling. It also shields the tungsten while it's cooling. If your tungsten is turning blue or purple, it's probably because you pulled the TIG torch away before the tungsten was adequately cooled. That could cause those tungstens to become discolored. Also, at the end of the weld puddle, you know on this one here, you'll see that there's a crater on the end. To eliminate that crater, as you're feathering off the foot pedal, add one more dab of your filler metal onto that crater. You can also backstep the TIG torch a little bit, and I'll demonstrate that right now.
So you see I'm keeping the tungsten down close to the workpiece while the post flow is coming out the torch. That's going to cool the end of my weld puddle and keep my tungsten from contaminating.
So you can see here that there's no crater on this weld bead that I just put down versus the one that I didn't fill in at the end. In part four, we'll talk about some of the advanced settings of the machine to help fine-tune the welding arc.